Today I'm going to show you how you can put some wood under the microscope so maybe we're able to see a few cells. And we'll also be looking at the wood using different lighting techniques. So hi, hello and welcome again, Microbehunter here. If you want to prepare some wood, we have to make sure that it's sufficiently small. And in order to do that, you need a razor blade, and we're going to be cutting the wood into very, very small cross sections. This is a fresh razor blade. You want to always start off with fresh razor blades because otherwise there is the danger that you slip and that you cut yourself. But it's pretty dangerous of holding it because there is also a sharp edge on the on one side. So for protection, I recommend that you take some tape and that you actually glue it, stick the tape here on one side so that you do not hurt yourself. So, and now we're able to hold it, to hold it like this. Otherwise, there's a danger of cutting yourself. Still, there is a danger of cutting yourself, so you got to be careful. So I would like to now shave off very, very thin cross sections of the wood in different orientations, like this and also like this. And we're going to collect it on this microscope slide here, and then we're going to put it under the microscope, and maybe we're lucky. Yeah, you really need to shave off very thin layers here, and you do need a little bit of patience as well. And I think maybe this is already enough for first try. Let's add a little bit of water first, and then a cover glass. Yeah, here we go. Okay, so that is already at the first sample. I'm able to see that the cross section is very thin, so we are already at a cellular level. So you can see that even with a sharp razor blade, you can make very thin cross sections. What are we able to see over here? Yeah, those dark round structures here, these are a few air bubbles that are left over. And then you can also see that there are different cells running crisscross into different directions here. I just need to refocus here a little bit. Let's go up with the magnification a little bit. Yeah, the beautiful colors that you see here are because of the polarized light. What is this here? There's even something moving on here. I don't know. Oh my gosh, I didn't expect that. This must have been probably in the water that I added. Yeah. Not in the wood, because it was dry wood. So you see there are always a few surprises here. But my point really here is that, we are now able to see cells running crisscross into different directions here. And now let's try a different cross section here, because this is now the longitudinal section. And now let's try the cross section of the wood. Okay, same as before, just with the wood turned now 90 degrees. Let's try to shave off again. It's not so easy. Yeah, because the cells are now running across, and therefore I have to get a cross section, and that is a little bit more difficult. Yeah, here we go. That's actually what I wanted to show you here. Now the individual cells in cross section are much better visible. I think it looks pretty nice, really. Let's focus a little bit. I'm now using my 20 times objective. Let's go up with the magnification here. Yeah, 40 times, and now, of course, the individual cells are quite nicely visible. Wood actually has a very, very strong, as we know, and because the cell walls of the cells contain the substance called lignin, which is actually the wood, the chemical that wood is made of. Those individual round things here, these are the individual cells here. Let's have a look. Yeah, so you see over here the individual cells, cell walls. No cell contents, because we're looking at on the inside of the wood. The living part of the tree trunk is actually on the outside. You've also got cells that are running across like this to supply the different parts of the stem with water. So I think it's quite a nice one. Unfortunately, the specimen is not entirely flat. For this reason, I have to focus a little bit, some parts a little bit out of focus. But let's go up to the higher magnification. Here we go, 60 times objective. The colors that you see here, that's because of the polarized light. Let's try bright field. That is here is bright field. You can see that all of the structures are still quite nicely visible, not so many colors. Phase contrast, that's the last thing I'd like to show you today. Now here, this is in phase contrast. I think The other one was a little bit nicer to look at, but the patterns are quite pretty. I think usually plant cells, like for example this wood here, is always a very very nice specimen because the patterns are very nice, and it also allows you to practice a little bit making very thin hand cuts. And it actually shows that with a little bit of patience, you do not need a microtome, but you are also able to get very nice cross sections without any additional tools. Just make sure that you don't cut yourself. Yeah, and this here is now dark field. Using my low power 4x objective. Yeah, and if you like those microscopy videos that I'm making here, well, then I would like to invite you to subscribe to this channel, and wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you around in the next video. Bye-bye.